one mistake at 60 and possibly die. So yep. you have to make sure you're playing correct, unless he just straight up outplays Yez a majority of the time, forces him off stage, like we said, and he wins in the edge guard game.
Right.
Then I could see this going to a very fast set. But honestly, I like you said, you had a lot of experience in matchup. It's the same with me. Literally, if it got down to last hits, Sonic stayed in the corner. It's like, you come interact with me because I can run when the mistake happens. But if you make that one mistake jump, you eat the fair and now you're off stage.
Yep, that's definitely true. One of the issues is going to be interesting to see here is that with Ike, you know, doesn't necessarily have a bad time getting back to stage. If you get too aggressive with an Ike off stage, especially if they're not like down a stock, the problem becomes like, hey, dude, I've got to move and I will take both of us. Like together,
true.
Like it's not a big deal. So with Sonic, though, he likes to go off stage. He likes to try and chase him with those back airs, trying to get those stocks by the blast zone. He likes to throw out that spring as well. And honestly, we're probably going to see a lot of the spring,
yes,
trying to catch Ike or Yez just, you know, being way too aggressive, or even if he goes low, because a lot of times we'll see Yez will go low, but then like he'll jump and then air dodge to the stage. If he's not careful, a spring could be there, forcing him into a stage tech situation. Got to make sure he's ready for it.
That's actually a very good point too, because Quick Draw will lose the spring every time it goes directly at ledge. It will hit spring first, so that's going to force Yez into a lot of situations where he has to recover high,
yeah,
instead of that, or early air dodge to potentially try and mix up his ether timing to get back,
yep,
to stage. But you don't really want to ether too much because the top of that spring could also just knock him away if it catches the head portion of Ike in that spin. So it's going to be on Sonic to make sure that he's consistently punishing him at the ledge using that spring. That might be the main tool in the matchup in terms of Sonic being able to successfully win off stage.
Mm.
But also, like you said, if he messes up, and he's directly in front of him, he's taking, yep, him for a ride.
Oh,
and they're,
yeah,
both going straight down to blast zone. Or if he happens to be right next to the ledge, just falls for free at zero. So I'm curious. What's your view on this right now?
I mean, what I'm thinking is that I think Koopa hit something that's very important, right? Because it is a scenario. It's tough for Sonic. But there are specific scenarios in which Sonic can shine. We're, mm-hmm, talking about this off-stage scenario, right?
Mm-hmm.
If you get that back throw, granted, doesn't throw as harshly as it did before. But still, you're sending him off stage. You can play the game of, can I read your double jump? Right?
Yes.
Because if the moment you read Ike's double jump, suddenly that recovery becomes piss poor, dude.
Yeah.
It becomes so bad. And from that scenario,
yeah,
Sonic can just like kind of just forward air, spring back. It doesn't really, like, he has options there. So if Sonic wants to play that game where it's like, I'm run to the corner and then just kind of like try to bait you into a back throw and do that over and over, there's a pretty good chance he'll be able to come out on top. But stages do matter as well,
yes,
right? Because if he has like a platform he can quick draw to, that'll give him some more options. So we'll see. It's going to be close.
Yeah,
or it won't be.
true.
One or the other.
I think this could be another situation where we possibly don't see Smashville allowed. Obviously, that's a great stage for Ike to be able to do it. Actually, we might see a lot of Town and City. That's a very happy medium for both. You get the FD layout, you get the platform pressure, mm, from Ike, and it's easy for Sonic to camp along those side platforms to get away. And also, it's good for Ike to have a different route. Both of them want to kill early off the side. It's kind of like, hey, look, this is a happy middle ground for all of us. We're going to,
yep,
start here on PS2, but I wouldn't be surprised if after PS2, the main counter pick ends up being Town and City. But we're going to be getting finally into game number one here. We got Yez versus Sonics. I think this one is going to be ridiculously tough for both players. These are two potential winners of the bracket today. There's a reason why I was pointing out why I think Yez is an incredible pick. But Sonics has been a fiend for the W's online throughout the entirety of this era. We've outpassed our offline, mm-hmm, era while online. And Sonics has been a big name. You've seen it all the time during,
oh,
the,
yeah,
weeklies.
I think you've seen this
matchup a few times, too. How are you feeling about it going as we start here in game one?
I think generally, I believe Sonics has the lead. I can check that in a little bit. But it's definitely a tough matchup. It's not free by any means for either player here. But I believe Sonics does have the advantage. Now, as we move forward, a lot of it does come down. Is Yez ready to land those big hits? And as long as you're able to do that, it can be a really bad time for Sonics. But we're going to get started here. Both of them kind of taking their time, being careful around each other. And this is what Yez is ready for this, man. He knows this matchup. He knows what these two have been through. It's just a matter of just getting it all going.
I'm not going to lie. I thought we were in a button check.
Yeah, that was definitely an awkward, like, first date.
That was really weird. Yeah, no, nobody ready to budge and make the move. Oh, yeah, there's that ether attempt. And he holds on to his jump. So after he goes for that, he's able to dodge, mm-hmm, the spring. Because we already saw the immediate up B. But that even the emergency get out of jail up B can still potentially just give Ike.
Oh, that was a big problem there. So Yez likes to go for that Aether and then land back at ledge, and he actually missed space at that time. That's why Sonics was able to get a lot of damage out of that one.
Okay, here we go. Spin dash cross through. Which is actually, it looks like Yez is kind of putting himself in the corner a lot. Just so for that spin dash, he doesn't really have the option to like, oh, I'm gonna jump and go to the platform, right? It's like, oh, I'm jumping and now I'm off stage. And in that scenario, it's like, well, now I'm the one in superior position.
Yeah, no, that's a great point you bring up there. You know, like I mentioned, when you already commit to spin dash, your options for stopping yourself are very limited. So if you're Yez and you're like, okay, if I play backwards a bit, you know, it's gonna give Sonics, you know, less of an option to follow up on me. Or, you know, you get a scenario like that where you get spin dash into up air and the first set of up air decides to show up to work that thing.
You know, another interesting point about that, too, is that essentially playing at that range, you're almost kind of pseudo making your own Smashville. You're cutting the stage in half. You're making it so Sonics can't react. Like, just full screen, oh, I see you running at me. You're slow as hell. I'm going to back off a little bit and react. Now, when you play him in the corner, you have to make sure you don't make the wrong mistake. That he still has his jump. He holds on to quick draw and decide not to jump. But that F tilt is going to find first blood, and that goes to Sonics. And that is the last thing you want to be looking at in a set that could be very close down to the wire.
Yeah, right now it's definitely been a very good back and forth here. I mean, 97% is really not that bad. Yez has been doing a good job maintaining at least a percentage lead for a little bit of that, but then Sonics was just starting to find his openings. And there we go, gonna get that one up air. Not gonna be able to get the follow up, and that's what you gotta be careful of. You're gonna follow up, and with anything, you gotta make sure you're on the money, because otherwise you start losing stocks like that.
Frame trap machine, you're forced to air dodge, otherwise you eat that up air, and then if you're just free falling afterwards, you're gonna get blown up. It's so hard to dodge after that air dodge is gone, and just Yez capitalized on it immediately.
Yeah, you see both players, again, just trying to scrap for positioning in the middle of the stage right now. You see Sonics, you know, doing that. I do like that, you know, the different ways that he goes about, you know, changing his in his spin dash trajectory, like what he does. You know, because you can still air dodge out of spin dash. You can still, you know, you see a lot of players down air and stuff too. Mm-hmm. And you see why Sonics is taking his time. Whenever, you know, you miss something on shield against Ike, he does have really, really strong low percent combos like you saw right there.
Oh, there we go. A little bit of a juggle in the back air. Going to push him off stage a little bit. Had the double jump and was able to get to the ledge. But one thing I am noticing here, that in these scenarios where we see Sonics get Yez off stage, Yez kind of tries to take the approach that's the quickest to get back to the ledge, right? Mm-hmm. So now I'm wondering, okay, well, if he's going to the ledge a lot, that means you now open up the possibility of going for a ledge trump and then trying to get a KO that way. So I'm going to be seeing if he makes that adjustment. He may not. Doesn't really need to. His current game plan is working pretty well, but it'd be a nice thing to see.
Something he might also do on a lot of air dodges is you can use side from Sonic to put a hitbox out on that air dodge, catch the ending of it, and confirm in the back air. So that's another possible thing too. Now, he was forced to recover high, and this matchup is kind of like a he who swings first loses, and it's so hard to get around it. He still has this jump, I believe. No, he activated quick draw though, and he still gets punished because he had the spacing. That was another blow taken from Sonic's, and Sonic's is going to take another stock lead.
Yeah, listen, like we brought it before, edge guarding and ledge trapping is going to be a huge X factor in this set for Sonics if he wants to, you know, continue on here and get himself a lead. And right now he's doing a pretty good job of it. Again, Sonic with the lead, it's a totally different beast than, you know, when it's at even stocks or at a deficit. You see Sonics is patiently waiting and, you know, utilizing that jump up air as an approach tool. You know, not nearly as potent as it was in Smash 4, but still, you know, occasionally good enough to get the job done, as we see a great array right here.
Oh, man, yeah.
This
damage just continues to pile up, and this is exactly what Sonics is capable of. Like, yeah, all of your hitboxes are on your body, essentially, right? But so it could be an issue. Like, you know, some characters can struggle when you go against characters with huge disjoints like Ike. But the way that Sonics can actually play aggressive, which he does not get enough credit for, is absolutely insane. And look at this. I mean, right now he's got a full stock. Going to run up and just get that grab, putting him right off stage. See what the option is. Just going to let him get to the ledge. But, oh, he was definitely looking for that forward tilt. We're going to get that grab instead. That was just well played.
That was smart right there, too. Wow. Okay, look, quick draw, high percents, will KO. And you catch a mistake, it will take it. But you know what? Sonics is doing a good job of kind of passively moving around and recognizing defensive habits out of Yez now. You saw it. He walked back and forth at the ledge, but just saw he went for the roll. And he might be able to just sneak something out. Granted, you need to stay away from that ledge because Ether can just go ahead and cheat a stock away on you. So you have to be very careful for possibly getting snapped to the ledge with that upbeat. And I think that's why Sonics decided to dip after he realized that was a scary spot.
Yeah, I got a lot of damage racked up here on Yez. Yez still hasn't even gotten a hit yet, but that means the onus is on him to approach, right? So you can see Sonics is like, all right, I'm going to camp this corner, bro. Come to me. I will back throw you and then just try to close this game out. So Yez kind of swinging at his demons right now.
Yeah, definitely shadow boxing in the parking lot right now. But listen, I totally understand why he's doing it.
Agreed.
Because you know, there's always the off chance that Sonics decides to pull the trigger on spin dash. Like I said, your options are you know, you either go straight or you go straight up at a 45-degree angle. So you know, better not, better be safe than sorry in these scenarios. As Sonic's, you know, showing no intent of you know, surrendering any sort of stage position here.
Yep, and this is what exactly what I was talking about before. When a Sonic has a lead on last stock, what do? They run to that corner, say, come to me, because it's a linear approach. Oh, God, okay, see, this is what I was talking about before. If you fight too much in the corner, there's always the potential you just get ledge snap, upbeat, and die. Mm-hmm. So that's why Sonic is going to make sure he gets out of the corner and only pretty much fights center stage, maybe reads a jump and punishes it.
What was that quick draw attempt there? I don't know if that was just a misplay or something, but I mean, you're not in a bad spot because you didn't lose a stock for it. 177 is not like that's any different from the damage you just took, but yeah, Max Rage, you just pointed that out not too long ago. We could honestly see the stock disappear here if Sonic isn't careful, but nope. That back there, definitely going to be enough to close that out. I mean, so strong, so quick. I mean,
yeah, what can you do? There's only so much you can do, right?
Right.
Like, dare I say, the back air is nice.
That's your one.
I mean, sometimes it just it hit different.
Just saying,
you know, it really do. Like sometimes you just put the leg out.
I mean, it's kind of weird to say nice backer because every backer in this game is pretty nice if you think about it. Like, I don't think there's a bad backer.
Little backer like to have a word with you.
Oh man! Oh yeah!
I don't know why you're now making me think about bad backers in this game. There's
no bad backers.
He's like stretching to get out of bed.
Oh, man. Oh, but no, goodness. That was rough. There were 35 seconds left in that last game, so it really became a matter of, like, yeah, we saw Yez shadow boxing for a little bit, saying maybe if we spin dash, it's in, but then it became, I can't rely on that anymore because now the clock isn't on my side, so I have to run at him. Now I have to throw out something, and Sonic's just like, all right, wait, cool, here's the back air, boom.
That has always been one of the things about Sonic as a character that is, like, you know, even when earlier in the game where you know, some of his moves weren't always connecting. He was probably a little bit worse of a character then. Sonic is a character where no matter at what stage of the game, you have to play at his pace. Mm-hmm. You know, if you're losing, good luck. If you're winning, it is going to be death by a thousand cuts. So you know, he's always been a character where you know the pace of the game obviously you know is dictated by the Sonic player. So and listen, Sonic has a game to play with now. You know, we saw that it's Battlefield and Smashville that are off the stage. So you know, I lied to? No, just kidding. Small Battlefield. Yeah,
the other one. And honestly, I think one of the things that's going to
happen. The Battlefield at home.
Yeah. Work from home Battlefield.
This is small PS2. This is small PS2. I keep telling people that. It's literally the same platform. If it was a small Battlefield, we'd still have that third platform up top, but we don't have it.
Oh, my goodness. Okay, so that was quite a whiff punish right there.
Yeah.
Honestly, one of the things that makes it a really big struggle in this matchup, I mean, right now, yes, it's fine, his opening, but at high percent, Sonic's understanding that dash attack and quick draw, 7% or maybe a dash attack, are pretty much the only things that open up. And now the jump is expanded, but he gets back in. That was good, like, just patience. Or actually, just, like, good mental awareness on Yez to recognize, I can still make this back. I didn't get knocked away far enough.
Okay, and here we go. Neutral air. Going to go ahead carry him towards the top a little bit.
Ooh,
I like the down air, though. Cheeky on it. Keeping the juggle alive as well. That's what you like to see. Yes, though. I mean, he has my 84 if he gets that up air. Almost in.
Get red.
That was so good. Recognizing that he's been very defensive on a lot of these situations at KO percent. So he's like, okay, well, if I get punished here, I'm at 146. Mm-hmm. I'm going to die soon anyways, much like right now. But because he got that up smash, I think it was like, 80%?
Around there,
That was an enormous W for Yez in that situation.
But a great catch with the forwarder right there. Frame 4 move. Super strong. You know, that move has experienced quite the glow up in recent years. So, you know, we're back to even stocks here. But it is Yez, once again, a steady diet of Nair and Fair. Really adding on some good damage here.
Yeah, and this is one of those situations that gets a little weird because Sonic has to start approaching a little bit more sometimes. He wasn't in any danger of losing that stock right there. There was going to be no spike to the bottom blasted at all, but could be at stock.
Nice!
That's how you capitalize. Mm-hmm. Got the air dodge out. It's like, this is a frame trap to narrow. You can't do anything now. You use your dodge. Boom! Forward air comes out and you're gone.
Remember what we were saying before, frame trap machine. He was catching him on the ledge on the platform with that near the back air and such, and he started recognizing, he's reacting after my first swing, and then he gets him on that air dodge right there. Now he's gonna be big. Uh-oh. He needs to hold this lead because now Sonic's is starting to push go. He's starting to hold forward, and that's a bad thing, especially with that counter at the ledge. You have to watch out for your recovery now.
No jump.
Oh, wow. Yeah, you know, there's too many frames at the end of that air dodge, and he just wasn't able to get back to the ledge. So that was a little bit unfortunate. And now you're going to lose the percentage lead here. And that's the problem. And around the final stocks, I mean, Yez has been controlling the pace of the game, dictating the tempo for so long. And now it's all of a sudden in Sonic's favor. And Sonic's going to do his thing, man. He's going to get his hits in. He's going to, you know, take his time. He doesn't have to approach as crazy anymore.
Yep. Yeah, great punish option off of that quick draw on shield. Like I mentioned, forward air is Sonic's fastest aerial. It comes out frame four, like I mentioned, so it's going to be a great out of shield option. And now, like we saw, you know, it's going to be you're Sonic, so you're going to sit on this lead. You're going to force an approach. But right now, you know, it's looking a little hairy for you.
Oh, yo, Yez called out three different places where that quick, spin dash went. And then he catches him again on the landing down. This is 95% trying to find the ground. He gets back, but this is now nair windows. Yeah, you see he's looking for nair to up air windows. Potentially could be the KO or even a dash attack mistake at the ledge if Sonic decides to run away.
Yeah, there we go. We're going to get that first nair, putting him right up above. And that's exactly where Yez wants people, man. He wants them right above him so he can hit those up airs, because those nairs just to continue things, just to try to find a way to take that stock. But 102%, man, Sonic should be nervous, and it's situations like that that lead into a game for Yez. We're getting into a one game apiece scenario. I mean, game three, it's do or die.
Can we go back to that second stock really quick? Because I need to point out how ridiculous Yez was in that position.
Yep.
He just kept calling out. He caught the first spin dash at the very end of his way back in. It's going to show up here in a second. Not there just yet. Wrong stock. But next stock is coming up. He was able to catch him repeatedly on his way back in. Okay, I guess I was just completely wrong. I wish Shaka was. It was the first one. But he's just doing so good at regularly calling out all of his approaches, and it made it so he really couldn't do much about it. Like, even after the pressure that Sonic was putting on, he's like, oh, wait. Spin dash is going up here by the platform. Then you're going to try quick spin dash again from the ledge. And he just kept making him regret every single time he approached. Okay, I think we actually finally found it. Here we go. So he's gonna come in, catch him right here, and then he forces him to go back down. No, we didn't. We didn't see any of that situation. So, Yez was calling out all of those spin dashes. I was completely wrong.
It was in the middle of a stock.
It was just really good that he shut down all that pressure, and that's hard to do as a character who's pretty predictable with his hitboxes in terms of dropping down with nair, dropping down with falling up air, easy to react from Sonic. Now we're going to game three. We're going to be running it. No Kalos, no FD available. Very obvious counter picks in this matchup. I'm curious to see if it was time. Are we finally seeing the Town and City pick? Here it is.
All right, well, here we go. We're going to be getting started into this game three here, man. Both players with a game under their belt so far. It's going to be interesting to see who can find that first opening. Now, we talked about it a little bit earlier about how these platforms help Yez get these combos. And then when you get to the final destination aspect of it, you know, it's a little bit better for Sonic. So it's definitely a good stage for both of them. So what are you guys expecting from both these players moving forward?
So majority of the beginning of this, we're going to be seeing a lot of this platform pressure here in the center, but now that it's gone, exactly what you're saying before. It makes it, now all the options are linear out of Ike. He either quick draws in or he goes in with the nairs. Granted, he's been fighting him a lot. Flambo, how are you liking the adjustments so far from Yez at the beginning? Even though he's slightly behind, it seems like he's playing a much more aggressive approach at the start.
Yeah, I'm feeling like for Yez here, the platform setup is going to matter a lot, right? Like this one right here, this is essentially the Kalo setup. This one isn't going to do too much. If he manages to get like a nair into forward air and it pushes him on the plat, he can go for like a tech chase. But we saw back on Small Battle Field, when he had that PS2 layout, he was able to convert a lot off of those knockdowns on the platforms here. So when he gets kind of like the tri-platform layout, I think that's going to be the most effective for Yez.
Ooh. Yeah, you saw why the platform layout right there could have been a game changer. As even though Sonic didn't convert to forward air, he kind of jailed Yez on the platform. But both players are going to be able to survive right now. Sonic's trying to get the punish right here and potentially the stock. But Yez doing a great job playing keep away.
Yeah, even at these percent windows with 65-121, you see Sonic is fully aware that one mistake could potentially not only cost him a stock, but get him a position where he can't afford to just run in. Right there, it's Town and City, so luckily he stays alive a little bit longer, even with that KO power. And I know it's only 88, but the fear factor now sitting in his head, like, oh, I make one more mistake like that, I could possibly die. And even Yez, with the heavyweight of Ike, is going to be hard to get off the top. He needs to force him at ledge, possibly kill him with an F-tilt.
Yeah, this is one of those scenarios where it's like, all right, I need to KO him right now, so like I don't have to worry about this rage anymore. You know, it's like one of those moments where it's like, he could take my stock right now and then really carry this into a lead,
Okay, that was a little interesting. Yeah, it kind of fell out of that spin dash. Back throw going to be able to close that up. Yes, sir, it will be. So kind of a tough situation here for Yez, because now you're down a stock, right? And you're getting a little bit extra credit on you, man. There's just nothing you're going to be able to do about that. So it's like, he's got to find a way to grind this all back, because the entirety of game two, he had basically a lead until Sonic stole it for just a little bit. And then all of a sudden, Yez was like, all right, I got this. So you got to find a way to not just turn this around, but you got to find a way to, okay, that's a good start. We're going to see that forward tilt close out that first stock.
Yeah, that dash attack, while I like the idea from Sonic, it did leave him, unfortunately, open and stuck in the corner right there. As you know, Yez trying to get himself back in this game here, but it's been a real steady diet of not just spin dash, but the spin charge has also been huge for Sonic. The downbeat, attacking on a lot of really good damage.
All right, and here we go. It looks like, based off what we're seeing so far, Yez has been playing his second stock a lot slower than the first, right? He's like, I gotta mount this comeback slowly. Was able to finally get the first stock, but still on the back foot here. Can't seem to find a way back down to the ground. It's gonna be another punish. Is he gonna air dodge back down again? No, he uses the quick draw, so an offensive option.
Nope.
He wanted it.
I respect that attempt, because if you're able to find that, now you're at an even game after 19% to 135. And for Sonics, this is so bad because Sonics was controlling everything before, and now he's being forced into bad defensive options. Actually, that one was a pretty smart one, but you have to run away scared. But there's that forward air, and he gets him off the top, and that is good damage mitigation, because that could have gotten so bad so fast.
Yeah, we're going to be getting into probably the home stretch here. 52% in the second stock, and just going to find ways to build up this damage. And Yez is certainly in trouble. That's a good start. Another forward air, not going to be able to close out the stock. Quick draw. I think he was looking for the drop off.
I love that pressure. You make it look like he's going to do something at the ledge, but now he's stuck at the ledge himself. Doesn't find the up air.
Yes.
That is a completely reactable air dodge down. We are on last stock potentially here in the game number three. We're going to keep it moving forward. I don't work people in chat. Stress, but my God.
You see Sonic's. Ooh.
It's getting scary now.
I don't blame him, man. Like, this is a scary matchup. Great neutral air right there from Sonics. And again, the spin charge being huge right there. Ooh. Not going to be able to punish the air dodge from Yez. He was just a little bit too far out of reach.
Yeah, I think he wanted the dash attack, but he got the forward tilt instead.
It's going to be a little interesting to see how the rest of this plays out, because it's going to be a lot of straight hits going between both these characters. And we've kind of known that was going to be the case anyway. But right now it's 87 to 27, right? So Yez got to find some big hits and quick. 2 minutes left on the clock, so it's not the worst case scenario. And you are starting to get a little bit of rage. 130 could be scary. So I got to be careful.
Oh, he doesn't get the air dodge down punished. Oh, my God. Is he going to get him? Spun the roulette wheel, but did not land on Black. Man. He was hoping to risk it all and try to get that KO. And I understand why he did that, too, because after the last few attempts, right, Sonic just needed to win one more situation to get him 113 or so, get that back air. But after that, you're like, you know what? Maybe I'll rely on some Swiss cheddar. He tried to get the cheese, hopefully get that double KO, get him knocked out early, but sometimes it doesn't work in your favor. And that is Sonic's moving on. Honestly,
let's see that replay one more time, just so we can kind of all collectively, breathe, watch in slow motion. So as we see here, the edge guard is set up, and a great catch it looks like it was a neutral get up. And, Yez was giving up a lot of those air dodges. Unfortunately, Sonics wasn't always punishing them. And here
Jesus,
we go.
Jesus, take the wheel.
He goes for it.
There was no way he was going to be able to take that.
He was low percentage. I respect it, but, unless you're off stage, there's just no way. No way that Sonics was going to die first there. I don't know.
And listen, at that point, I get it. It's a last game scenario. You might as well just, throw it all on Black, like you said. And unfortunately, the gamble did not work out for Yez as Sonics. Continues to move on here. Again, it's been a good day for Sonic the Hedgehog mains.
Yeah, that's true.
Sonics is undefeated on stream.
Yeah. So far, Kraftus and Sonics. Sonics back at the Olympics. Congratulations to him, I guess.
So, doing it again. Before we get there, Ajax, you want to tell us who's going to be on next?
I will not, because we're going to talk about some ads first, because no production, we're not doing that.
Can you tell me who's next?
All right, so they're trying. So possibly, we maybe might possibly have Sparkle versus Shiny Mark next. But y'all just trying to get me in trouble.
Can you please tell me who's next on
Look them in the eye. Look directly in that camera.
Look, the camera's right on you. Can you please tell the lovely people at home who's next on stream?
Hey, Jax, don't you play with me, boy.
Versus Shiny Mark is up next. Look, somebody save me. I needed a doll.